AJ, what do you got?
The old tunnel.
Yeah, that's twice, right? You don't want to damage that. The wind is insane. Okay, so what's the story?
A guy on Facebook said that he had dreams.
And?
And they were damaged.
Oh, cool. But they were a Dreamcast, and you never get Dreamcast games. What'd you pay for everything?
45.
Okay, how many games?
20-something.
Are you going to show me each game, or?
Yeah, so I'm okay. Going to take them out first.
Oh, take them out. Okay, so I'll just focus on you so everybody can get a preview. There's one that's a real winner. Well, there's one game that you went there God damn it. There's one game that you went there specifically for. Okay, so it'll work out in the end.
He's not a problem.
All right. Okay, you ready? Should I just start? Save the best for last. NBA 2K, what's this worth? Devil 2 Crimson. I'm not familiar with that. Is that a good one?
Yeah.
How good?
It's okay.
But Japanese price-wise? This can't be that valuable. Yeah, no, I could see. I see. So basically, you got a disc.
Yeah.
So you paid 45, and how many games? 15?
20-something.
Oh, 20. So it's about two and change a game. Yeah. Okay, Atari, this can't be that valuable of a game, right?
No.
This game is the generic game that would that everybody has, but this is still worth like...
Yeah. Yeah.
This isn't really worth much, right? Okay.
Like
what about this one? Death Crimson.
15.
Okay, now compared up with this one, it looks like you got a 1 and a 2, right?
Yeah, but this one's American.
Oh. Oh, so only people with Japanese Dreamcast can play it?
See, the war damage, you gotta, like,
yeah, no, no. The way to do that is put it in water and let it soak. Yeah. Take it out, and then the paper will kind of just fall off of it. Crazy Taxi.
You can see the staples rusted.
Yeah, I can see. Yeah. And look, it's show the inside a second. People, don't store your games in the basement, please.
Except if you're me.
Or the attic.
Who stores them out in the flood zone.
Yeah, if you're worried about floods. Or put them in a bucket. Oh my God. See what I said about the wind here?
Hydro Thunder.
Hydro Thunder, who cares, right?
Okay.
Dead or Alive.
Another Sonic.
Another Sonic, which means one of them may not work.
Yeah.
What's this? Extreme Racer. House. Is this another $8 to $10? Yeah. You know how hard these are to sell? How are you going to sell these? Like loose disc binder? Or as is watered down?
People always ask.
They always ask, but they don't want these games. The next Tetris Online Edition. NFL 2K.
And this is a sealed game that's water damaged.
Oh, son of a bitch. Where's the water damage? Oh, yeah. On the staples.
Oh,
too damn bad. That's the winner. How's the back look?
That'll come off.
Oh, okay. Yeah, that'll come off. Yeah, any games that have paper on them, just throw them in. Fill your sink or something with water. Throw it in, and
so
after like 5 minutes.
Piece for these?
Yeah.
I'll show you the last one.
Because you're paying for loose discs, so
no,
it's...
I'm going to get this as well.
And how much extra?
That's Marvel for free.
He's I can't really see it.
Marvel vs. Capcom.
Marvel vs. Capcom. So it's a throw-in.
Well, no, throw-in. He forgot it.
But, yeah, but it's a throw-in now.
Yeah.
Because he's going to... How's he going to get it to you? You got to pick it up or he's going to mail it to you?
I told you. Figure out...
Just tell him to mail it and pay him for the shipping. Yeah. Give him, like, $5. And say, hey, look, here's $5.
So I'm going to sell these, like, these tomorrow to metal.
Why not? People ask. You never know. Well, it's something you could see, even the plastic stuff. You gonna photograph it now?
Yeah, I'm just gonna do like.
Do you want to talk about your Amazon experience now or no?
Really quickly, because I'm blocked in and I got doctor's
plan. I know. Okay, so how Amazon basically kicked AJ off? They said it's because he has too many returns. AJ is having problems with people that are trying to scam him, fraudulent buyers, right? So AJ was calling back and forth to Amazon, and this is how AJ wound up being treated by Amazon. They said you can't even call him anymore, right?
No, you gotta pay to call.
Now, how much do you have to pay to call?
$10 a call.
$10 a call, just to call him when there's a problem, right?
Yeah.
So that's one how they're treating him. First of all, it's like they automatically don't believe AJ. They go with the buyer all the time, right? And they just let the buyers do it over and over. It's not like they couldn't just identify bad buyers and kick them off at some point or allow you to provide them with some kind of feedback to say, this guy might be a bad buyer. Put him on a watch list or something like that. I mean, you do it in a store. If somebody goes in a store and shoplifts, right? They take a picture, they catch him, they take a picture. They say, if this guy comes in, he's a shoplifter, he's a thief, he steals. They should do that on Amazon, but whatever, right? I don't even know if they block buyers on Amazon. I don't know. Can you imagine what they'd have to do to block a buyer on Amazon? It would be ridiculous. But so easily, they'll block a seller in a half a second, right? That's why I left them, but whatever. So first they go like this to you. They go, you got to pay $10 to call them to work out a problem, right? Every call, right? So then you're like, fine, you're emailing them, right? And what happens?
They're not going to respond to me anymore.
They're not going to respond. They're not even going to respond. Give them the dignity of talking to them through an email anymore, right? So they say, okay, we're not going to do that, right? And then what is that when they kick you off?
Yeah,
because you know why they kicked him up? Because he was too much trouble. He bothered me. He had some problems. He needed some help, right? So how's it stand now? What's the kicker?
They owe me $700.
They owe him $700. How long do you have to wait to get your money from them?
3 months.
3 months.
I already threatened a lawyer, and they're like, oh.
Yeah, they're like, we're Amazon. We don't care. You know, because they already know you're not going to sue. It's full of crap. I would tell them what I told you to do. First of all, I would say I would try one more time. I would try through Twitter. And I would try through Facebook to see if you get results. Because on Twitter, they post the responses. They seem to be more helpful. And maybe you could shame them somehow. You know, but I told them if it was me, I would be like, yeah, here's what's going to happen. First of all, I'm canceling all my Amazon listings. I'm canceling my Amazon Prime. I'm never buying on Amazon again. Plus, I'm a blogger. And I would lie. I would say I have thousands and thousands of people who view my video, right, who will see this video talking about the experience. And by the way, I'm recording this phone call. Or I've recorded and detailed all the emails that go back where you told me this and where you've treated me like total crap. Because Amazon, you should remember, we customers, we sellers are also customers. But okay, so...
Now, how would you sell these?
Those? I don't know. Do it. Just try and sell them to someone in person. Let them clean it off or whatever.
Okay.
Yeah. Just sell them for a loose disc price, maybe a little bit less. And the best one is where you make your money back on. That's your gravy.
This one I'm just putting out online. I'm just taking it with
yeah.
me. These I'll leave with you.
Okay. Let me know if there is there anything else you want to say about like what's going on with Amazon. You know, or
it's just very stressful.
Yeah, because now you're banned. You can't sell. You're banned for life. Is what they said, banned for life, because some people were
most... They want to keep the items.
Oh, they want to keep the items and get the refund.
Like,
and you know what they tell you? And I understand this. If you're a big, big seller, they tell you, hey, suck it up. Suck it up. Right? They go, oh, that's part of doing business. But you're not a big seller. So what would these sales have totaled for you? Or what did they total?
300.
300 in sales. Out of 900 or...
Yeah.
So they basically... Here's the worst part of it. You said they owe you 700,
yep.
right? And so that would have been they owed you 1,000, right? So basically 30% of the sales that you were made are like tossed in the trash. You have to give up on it because people are trying to get over. They won't just send the item back and let you do a refund. They want to keep it, right? Oh, it's too much trouble. Too much trouble. I'll just keep it. Yeah, it's easy for everybody. I'll just keep it. You give me my money. It'll be great, right? But I was going to say, like, big-time sellers, too, I understand what they say because it's like big money. They go, oh, just whatever. It's cut it as a loss. The other thing about Amazon that a lot of people don't realize is that you can't block buyers like on eBay. So the same person could do it to you over and over and over and over and over and over. You know, you just have to, they buy from you, have to cancel the sale.
Is they're like, oh yeah, wait until you get the refund. And then they file A to Z, you can't wait. You got a refund right there.
Right.
What the fuck?
Right. So it's like they protect them. Let me just see if the car, anything else to add or no?
Tomorrow, where are we going
to
be?
I already said we're going to be at the Meadowlands. If anybody wants to buy CDs, DVDs, and video games from us.
How about Sunday?
Sunday, we're going to Wayne Powell. Hopefully. This is
going
to be your own video. I'm going to name this AJ's Dreamcast Video Game Pickup and how Amazon treats, how badly Amazon treats their customers, you know? But, and if I need to, at some point, send me copies of emails and stuff like that so we can prove, like, what they're doing. I know you didn't record any of the phone calls where they're telling you, like, yeah, it's going to cost... I never heard of such a thing. It's going to cost $10 to talk to them. Unbelievable.
I'm putting online tonight. How about
you? Okay, yeah. I mean, you know, you never even take your Dreamcast out. So, all right. So, any shout-outs quick?
I'm going to post these on Mercari like this.
Nobody cares. Any shout-outs?
No.
Okay, bye. Okay. Go ahead. You're going to post on Mercari.